Today, so that you can either stack them or you can still have them for if and when you want to. Bolsters. Alright. I know of a few more individuals that are wanting to come. Hi, Jenna Moore. Hi, Jules. Hello. Guys, how does the volume sound on this music? Can you hear it? Yeah? Instagram's really screwing with us, isn't it? This is being recorded to go on YouTube, so at Instagram, I'm calling you out because I just can't have it all posted on my Instagram feed, you know? It's still gotta be a vibe. Anyways, we're gonna get started in a supported child's pose tonight. So make sure you do have your bolsters because we will be doing some restorative stuff, and you're going to need your bolsters. Make your way into child's pose. Sit your hips down towards your heels. Once you're there, just come to arrive here in this space. First with your breath, then with your mind. We're back. Here we are. We're back. Make sure you're just gonna get started in a child's pose. Guys, you're gonna get started in a child's pose with bolsters. So just go ahead and grab a bolster, you're gonna lay it along your stomach in child's pose. Come to lay flat. You might want one or two, whatever's comfortable for you. Sit your hips back towards your heels. Maybe you even inch your fingertips forward. Come to arrive here in this space, first with your breath and then with your mind. And notice how this supported child's pose feels a little bit more more grounding than normal. If your fingertips reaching out in front of you doesn't feel good, reach back around for your heels. And then drop one cheek to your mat and just feel supported right here by your pillow. Grounded in on your mat tonight for this yogic practice. To not only sweat for a minute, but to also ground into yourself, into your breath. Take a deep inhale through your nose, fill all the way up. Audible exhale out through your mouth, release. Sigh it out. Do that again. Big inhale through your nose. Audible exhale out. Release. Start to notice your chest rise and fall, the back of your rib cage rise and fall. And just feel grateful for your heart beating beneath your chest. This time, cultivate your ujjayi breath. Seal your lips. Same inhale through your nose. Ujjayi breath back out. Slide your bolster out of your way, just hold. Isometrically draw your wrists and your knees towards one another. And then step your right foot out wide if you have enough space for a wide leg cat-cow. Ground down so that even the knife side edge of your foot is pressing down through your heel. And then inhale, cow pose, drop your belly, stretch through your inner thigh. Exhale, cat pose, press through your right foot and tuck your chin into your chest. That again. Inhale, cow. Make a smiley face with your spine. Exhale, cat. Tuck, round, and curl. Send your tailbone under. This time, come to find a flat spine, and then inhale, reach your right arm high. Send your gaze towards your fingers. Exhale, thread the needle. Send your right arm under. You can make sure to have your bolster nearby if you want to rest your head atop it, so that it becomes a little bit less intense of a stretch if you crave. But begin to engage through your core. Feel the outside line of your right shoulder open up. Breath in through your nose. Breath out. Plant back down through your left palm. Inhale, sweep your right arm back up high. Exhale, neutral tabletop. Take that all on the left. Step your left leg out. Inhale, cow pose, smile through your spine, open up. Exhale, cat pose, tuck round and curl. Do it again. Inhale, cow, open up through your heart space. Exhale, cat pose, open up through the backside of your ribs. Neutral spine, inhale your left arm high, roll out through your wrist, optional. Exhale, thread the needle, send your arm all the way underneath. If it's open for you, drop your left shoulder all the way down to your mat, but know that it's totally okay if it doesn't happen. It's really early in the practice. Try and still shift your hips forward over your knees so that you remain stacked and grounded rather than back towards your heels. This is a great time for my dog to be going through puberty where he wants to hump me. I'm sure this is content you've all wanted to crave all day. Root back down, inhale, sweep your left arm all the way back up high. Exhale, neutral tabletop position. Inhale, curl your toes under. Exhale, downward facing dog, shoot your hips up and back. First down dog of class, it could be even of your day, and that's okay, let it feel good in your body, right, Mr. Man? Please get off my leg, okay, or don't. Wiggle through one foot, wiggle through the other. Or maybe today you bring a slight bend into your knees and then shoot your tailbone a bit higher towards the ceiling. When you do that, notice how you stretch through your hamstrings. Take one more breath in your down dog. Inhale. Open mouth. Exhale. Release. Then inhale. Look forward. Gaze forward. Exhale. Ragdoll pose. Step your feet hips width distance or wider apart top of your mat. Take a generous bend in both of your knees and begin to sway it side to side. We're gonna be doing some elbow to elbow grip in your sun A. So maybe today you take an interlace at the nape of your spine where your neck attached to your head. And that's where you start to sway. It's up to you. This is your time to be right here. But if you have that grip, switch it out. Opposite fingertips on top. Nod your head no, shake your head yes. Be thankful for this breath, for your spine, for the ability to connect it all together. Then slowly release your grip. Come to toe, heel your feet to touch center line of your mat. And on an inhale breath, rise all the way up to standing with your head coming up last. Once you've made it there, find your hands in through heart center and flutter your eyes closed. Feel your feet beneath you. Feel grounded into this earth. Know that you are supported. The mantra that we'll be working through today in class is, I am a channel for grace. So important it is to be positive, to be that channel of grace. But what does that channel look like? What is your vessel telling about you right now? It's just as important to focus on what we're emitting as it is to make sure our channel is open and clean. Our mind and heart and body are taken care of. So let's use these 60 minutes, give or take, to work on that mind, body, soul component. Big breath in through your nose, fill up. Open mouth, exhale, ha, sigh it out. Seal your lips, same ujjayi pranayama in through your nose. Ujjayi breath back out through your nose, release. Flutter open your eyes, drop your palms down to your waist, and then let's flow. Inhale, mountain pose, reach your arms high up overhead, hold and breathe. Lift and engage through your quads, so much so that your quads lift up off your kneecaps and allow that to hinge your tailbone and line up your spine. Squeeze through your glutes and grow tall through your low core using your transverse abs. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, elbow to elbow grip overhead. Find a slight back bend through your heart space, so rock your weight to your heels. Shift your weight back and open up through your heart. Inhale to open. Exhale, side body stretch to the right. Keep your grip. Send your chin up over your left shoulder. Knit your low rib cage in. Stay grounded through both of your feet and stretch through your left side body. Inhale up through center, keep the grip. Exhale, side body stretch, opposite direction. You still have your elbow to elbow grip this time. Send your chin up and over in the opposite side. Relax your shoulders away from your ears. Knit your low rib cage in so that you actually use your strong obliques. Inhale. Exhale, forward fold, surrender all the way down. Inhale, halfway lift, reset. Exhale, crouch and curl. Tuck round and curl into a tiny ball. Tuck your chin into your chest. Tint up through your fingertips. If it feels good just this first time, open your knees wide. Walk your fingertips forward and feel the juicy inner thigh stretch that comes through that. Take one more breath in. Breath out, bring your legs together. Inhale back, halfway lift, find a flat spine. Exhale, high plank and lower all the way down to your mat. Ground down through your entire forearm and inhale to a sphinx pose. Hold right here. Every little portion of your forearm needs to be grounded down. Your elbows can almost graze your hips. Send your belly button towards your spine. Let's all just respect the hustle that Peyton has right now. It's like, I want to hump you so bad. God love him. Pour one out. Send your gaze all the way forward. He's such a raging teenager. So many hormones. Lift up through your heart one inch further. Listen here. Inhale. Exhale, forearm plank. Curl your toes under. Lift your hips. Your forearms are still grounded. Every single portion. Your hips in line with your shoulders. Dome up the space between your shoulder blades to feel your rhomboids ignite. Nice, you're here for four. Here for three, you're going to walk into a dolphin pose, two and one. Lift your hips, walk your toes in, dolphin pose. Lift your hips and stay grounded through your forearms. Use this as an opportunity to open up through your triceps. Maybe even send your gaze towards your hands. This is a nice prep for a forearm stand. We're not doing it today, but eventually, if you ever want to, that's what you'll need in your body. You're here for four. Three. We're going to go downward facing dog in two. Listen here, press into your palms, lift your elbows, downward facing dog. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale, release. That's your son A. We'll flow. Inhale, look forward, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold. Make your way to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, reset. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose, root to rise. Exhale, elbow, grip, back bend, shine through your heart. Inhale, up through center. Exhale, side body stretch, right side. Inhale, back up through center. Exhale, side body stretch to the left. Inhale, up through center. Exhale, forward fold, swan dive to the ground. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, come round and curl, keep your legs together. Inhale, right back up, halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga, high to low plank. Jump or step back. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Shoot your hips up and back. Another time. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, forward fold, top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, reset. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain pose, sweep all the way up. Exhale, elbow to elbow, back bend, shine your heart. Inhale, up with your spine. Exhale, side body stretch, send your chin to the ceiling. Inhale, up through center. Exhale, same side body stretch, last time, left side. Inhale, up through center. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold, ride your breath down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, tuck, round, and curl. Open up through your lumbar spine. Inhale, back up, halfway lift. Number 7 with your body. Exhale, high to low plank, chaturanga. Flow through. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Takes your hips up and back. Big breath in through your nose. Big breath out through your mouth. Release. Do that again. Take advantage of your breath. Inhale. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Inhale, your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, modified pyramid. Extend your legs and hold. So your length of your stance is never going to change. Your legs are still far apart. And your feet are like they're on train tracks. Nice and separated from one another. Maybe you even flex your front ankle this first time to dig deep into your hamstring and calf and work your nose down to your knee. Especially if you did a lot of running today. Julie, I'm looking at you. Hinge at your hips. One more breath in to lengthen through your nose. Exhale to a low lunge. Step your left foot back. Inhale, simple twist. Reach your right arm high. Hold and breathe. Squeeze through your glutes to protect your low spine. Send your chin up towards your right fingertip. Your hips are nice and square to the ground. Begin to draw your inner thighs in towards one another. Then come up onto your fingertips of your left hand like you're going to lift up because you are. Inhale, open arm twist. Reach up, hold, and breathe. Commit to the lunge through your right leg. It's a lot in through your right quad. I know. Notice if you can take your left hip forward, your right hip back, and send your gaze back towards your right fingertips. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge. Hook your left elbow outside of your right knee. Squeeze through your glutes to protect your low spine, and send your gaze up and over your right elbow. Note where your thumbs are in space. If they're up by your shoulder, try and pull them in towards the center of your chest. Then slowly send your gaze towards the top of your mat. Inhale, chair pose, big movement. Sit your hips low, reach your arms high, hold and breathe. Arms all the way up overhead. Rock your weight into your heels and sit nice and low. Relax your shoulders away from your ears and draw your inner thighs towards one another. So to tone your glutes rather than your quads, see if you can get your ass lower again. All about that booty tone. Big movement again. Inhale, diver's pose. Come up on the balls of your feet. Pinch your shoulders forward like you're in a halfway lift and your palms back. You should feel like you're peering up and over the edge of a cliff. Knit your low rib cage in and send your belly button towards your spine. One more inhale. Exhale, chair plane, just ground down through your heels. Inhale, one-legged mountain. Lift your left knee, hold and breathe. Take your left hip down to meet your right. Think of 90-degree angles everywhere. Stomach to ankle, stomach to hip, knee to ankle, all at a right angle. Lift up through your right quad to grow tall. Inhale. Exhale, figure four. Hook your left ankle over your right. Now you have an option right here to stay. Or you have the option to work towards a toe stand where you work your palms down, maybe even onto your bolsters. Roll up on the ball of your right heel and sit your butt down to your heel. It's gonna be a big stretch through your quad and through your outer hip. It takes a lot of balance. You can use blocks, you can use pillows. Wherever you are, start to feel that juicy opening through your outer left glute. Regular figure four and four. In three, and in two, and one. Come back up to your figure four. Inhale, one legged mountain. Exhale, airplane pose. Step your left foot back, hold and breathe. Dial your left hip down to meet your right. And ensure your body is in a perfect T-shape from your head out through your heel. I love to flex my ankle on this one so that you really send energy even out through your Achilles as you lengthen it right here. For four, here for three. Crescent plane in two, and in one, land your crescent plane. Inhale, extended crescent. Reach your arms all the way up overhead and hold. This is lightning bolt pose from your heel out through your fingertips. Every single muscle should be burning. Stay right here, inhale. Exhale, warrior two. Dial yourself open. Find a 90 degree bend in your front knee. Dial your knee out towards your pinky toe. Big external rotation through your hip. Then inhale, reverse triangle. Straighten your front knee, send your top arm high. Also known as sky archer, you should feel like you're really reaching towards the sky above you. Inhale. Exhale, low lunge. Take your palms down to your mat. Listen here, left palm is your base. Inhale, side plank. Open up to the right side of your mat, just hold. Always an option to come down to your bottom knee and to hover your top leg off if you want to be more grounded to your mat. But maybe you find a tree pose with your legs. Step your right foot to the inside of your left, just like a tree pose, balancing. Four, three, chaturanga, in two, and one. Plant your palms high to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog. Yes, cease. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take your hips up and back. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale, ha, sigh it out. Set that all up on the left. Inhale, your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, extended pyramid. Extend through your front knee and hold. It's natural to want to open up through your hips, but take your right hip forward, left hip back. It's okay if your back heel never even touches the ground. That's not the point. Now surrender your nose closer towards your knee, even if that means finding a slight bend in your front knee. Nod your head no, shake your head yes. Do you remember? This is all about your body being a channel for grace, flushing out all of that shit you don't need so that you can show up a little bit more present for you and those around you. As far as inhale, the east, your heart is at peace. Exhale, low lunge, right here. Inhale, simple twist. Reach your left arm high and hold. For the time being, your weight is even between your left foot and your right hand. Now sweep your left shoulder a little bit further on top of your right and squeeze through your shoulder blades. Begin to bear more weight into your left foot. Inhale, simple open arm twist. Reach up and hold. Sink lower into your left leg. You need to commit to that lunge. This is all about building strength for your front leg. Yes, Jenna Moore. So good, Radish. Find length in your spine and rotate here. Inhale. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge. Hands to heart center. Hook your right elbow outside your left knee. Yeah, you can always drop down to your back knee. Yes, Julie. That will help you focus purely on your twist. If you want to work on your inner thigh core strength, stay right there in the revolved crescent lunge. One more inhale to lengthen, and an exhale to ring out your spine. Send your gaze forward. Inhale, chair pose, Utkatasana. Sit your hips low and hold. Not here for as long this time since you've already set it up. So sit 1 inch lower on your breath in. Breath out, diver's pose. Peer over the edge of your cliff. What do you see? Maybe even for a moment, you close your eyes. Click your heels together and trust in yourself. The worst thing that's gonna happen right here alone in your room is that you fall and get right back into it. Then inhale to lengthen. Exhale, chair plane, draw your heels down. Inhale, one-legged mountain. Your right knee lifts, just hold. Immediately pull your right hip down to meet your left. Stay flexed through your right ankle. And grow tall through your left quad, that muscle you just toned through all that twisting. Inhale. Exhale, figure four. Hook your ankles and hold. Begin to reintegrate into that outer hip. If you want to take the toe stand, first you walk your palms down slightly out in front of you, come up on the ball of your foot, and then down. This is so HPF-y. I like literally have taken 4 HPFs in my life, but here we are. Pour one out for core power. Remember that place? Same. Sit your hips up. Annie, I like how you just poured it out. Wherever you are, feel the opening in your hip. Begin to make your way back to your open, regular figure four. Inhale up, one-legged mountain. Release. Exhale, airplane pose. Step your right foot back. You're in a beautiful T-shape in your body. Send your belly button towards your spine. And don't forget about your arms. They're to your side so that you feel all that strength through your triceps and your shoulder blades. 4. Here for 3. Extended crescent in 2. And 1. Inhale, extended crescent. Reach your arms up and hold. Come up as high as you can on the ball of your right foot. Rotate your pinkies in towards one another to fire up your punching muscles, your serratus anterior. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, warrior two, take it open. Just for a transition, pull your left knee open to meet your ankle and to your pinky toe. Find length through each of your fingertips. Then inhale, reverse triangle. Sky archer pose, TikTok your arms and gaze. Send your gaze up towards your top fingertips. Keep your hips nice and level. Inhale. Exhale, low lunge, cartwheel your palms down. Right palm is your base this time. Inhale, side plank. Last pose of your sun V. Stack open and hold. Same variation you did on the other side, people. So maybe it's dropping to your knee. Maybe it's that tree pose in your legs. But I want you firing through your right side oblique as you lift your hips high. All the way into your side plank. Here for 4. You're here for 3. Chaturanga on deck. 2. And in 1. Yes, gal pal gal. Flow your chaturanga. We meet in downward facing dog. Take your hips up and back. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale, side out. What's standing between you and all your juicy restorative posture is 2 full flows of that. So let's get going. Inhale your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, extended pyramid, find length. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, simple twist, reach your right arm up. Exhale, open arm twist, press off and find length. Inhale to twist. Exhale, revolved crescent lunge, hook your left knee. Inhale, chair pose, step hard off your right foot. Exhale, diver's pose, peer over the edge of your cliff. Inhale to lengthen your spine. Exhale, chair plane, weights in your knees. Inhale, one-legged mountain, your left knee lifts. Exhale, figure 4, hook here. You're not holding it. Inhale, back up, one-legged mountain. Exhale, airplane pose, tee out in your arms. Inhale, extended crescent, long diagonal line. Exhale, warrior 2, dial yourself open. Inhale, reverse triangle, find a nice stretch. Exhale, low lunge, take it down. Left palm to your base, inhale, side plank. For 4, you're here for 3, chaturanga on deck in 2, and in 1. Always the option to just hold your plank. We'll all meet downward facing dog. Left leg, inhale your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, extended pyramid. Exhale, back to your low lunge.
Inhale, simple twist, rotate open. Exhale, open arm twist, lift your shoulders. Inhale to twist 1 inch deeper. Exhale, revolved crescent lunge. Gaze forward. Inhale, chair pose, sit your hips low. Exhale, diver's pose. Stay for your inhale, big breath in. Exhale, chair plane, drive your heels down. Inhale, one-legged mountain, your right knee lifts. Exhale, figure four, hook over your left knee. Inhale, back up, one-legged. Exhale, airplane pose. Inhale, extended crescent, land with grace. Exhale, warrior two, take it open. Inhale, reverse triangle, tick-tock. Exhale, low lunge, back down to your mat. Right palm to your base. Inhale, side plank, open up. Four, for three, chaturanga, two, and one. Plant your palms, chaturanga through. We all eat downward facing dog. Yes, Jen, one more time through each side. Grounding breath first, inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Inhale your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, extended pyramid. Exhale, back down, low lunge. Inhale, simple twist, rotate. Exhale, open arm twist. Stay for your inhale, twist deeper. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge, twist again, deeper. Gaze forward. Inhale, chair pose, sit low. Exhale, diver's pose, your heels lift. Stay, inhale. Exhale, chair plane, sit your hips low. Inhale, one-legged mountain, your left leg lifts. Exhale, figure four, sit low again. Inhale, right back up. Exhale, airplane pose, hinge your heart forward. Inhale, extended crescent, sweep forward. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, low lunge, take it down. Shorter this time, inhale to your side plank for four, three, two, chaturanga, and one. We'll all meet back, downward facing dog. Last side, inhale your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Inhale, extended pyramid. Exhale back, low lunge. Inhale, simple twist, rotate open. Exhale, open arm twist. Inhale, twist deeper. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge. Gaze forward. Inhale, chair pose. Sweep up. Exhale, diver's pose. Send your heart forward. Stay for your breath in. Breath out, chair plank. Inhale, one-legged mountain. Your right knee lifts. Exhale, figure four, sit down. Inhale, back up, one-legged. Exhale, airplane. Send your heart forward. Land your leg, inhale, extended crescent, sweep up. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse triangle. Exhale, low lunge. Right palm down, inhale, side plank, for four, for three, two, one. Chaturanga, final of class. We all meet downward facing dog. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale. Nice, Julie, I saw that. Inhale your right leg high. Exhale, half pigeon. Thread your right foot through. Reach for your bolster. So it's gonna slide either underneath your right glute or it's gonna be in front of you as a pillow that you can begin to fall forward on. I am dripping in sweat, so I hope you all are too. Begin to surrender your heart down. So nice to be able to see all of you. Teaching to an empty screen is really something special. I've always wondered if you guys actually all did it, or if you just texted or ate. Like, this would have been one of the classes I'd like log into and then go eat my dinner. No shame. What makes you come? In a yin practice, it targets your fascia, which is like all the cellophane that keeps your muscles together. So when you begin to hold postures for longer than a few minutes, that's when you get into that fascia. It's also when you begin to surrender into your parasympathetic nervous system, when everything begins to quiet down. Allow yourself to be heavy. and allow yourself to feel your presence. You've done about 30 minutes or so to work to flush out that channel within your body. But now it's time to go into the mental. To really find that space within you. Exhale, begin to feel yourself grow heavier on your mat. And know the power in that, the power of that release, that surrender, that realization that you're safe each and every time you arrive on your mat.
What's the fear of God in me?
Allow yourself to remain supported again right here. Slowly work your way back up onto your palms. Sit all your weight into your right hip and swivel your left leg around so that you're like in a seated tree pose. But make sure your left foot is towards the top left corner of your mat so it's slightly open. Bring your bolster on top of your leg. Then inhale, reach your arms up super high. Exhale, seated forward fold, Janushirasana, but with your bolster so that you can maybe rest your head. If it's there. If not, it's a nice thing for your elbows to be on as well. If you have a strap or if you want to use a t-shirt, you can always wrap that around your foot to enhance the length of your arms.
But right here, I want you to drop your head, neck, and shoulders, bolster or not, to feel heavy, to release that tension in your neck.
What's the fear of God?
Allow yourself to lose a little bit of control in your breath, knowing that you are safe right in where you are. See if you can flex into your ankle harder to drive more energy out through your heel. Then slowly rise up for a moment. Take your bolster out of the way. Bring your right hand right behind you. Inhale, modify gate pose. Shoot your hips up and hold. Send your hands and up. Send your chin towards your hand. Feel the opposite thing happening through your hips as you open up. Inhale. Exhale, right back down. If you crave a downward dog in between your half pigeons, go ahead and take it. Or just bend your left knee. Swivel your right leg around. It's up to you. Set up your bolster the same or different. If you have two and your hip feels better underneath a pillow, go ahead and slide one underneath your left hip, but then begin to surrender all the way down. I chose this mantra specifically because it was one of the first I used when teaching at the start of quarantine. Talked a lot about what grace looked like then. And if you're anything like me, grace has changed in the last 9 weeks, what that looks like. For me, this past week, it has been taking a week off to just exist on my own, to process whatever was going through my head, to admit that sometimes life gets a little hard, to admit that there's not a linear path like I so often wish there was. And allow for myself to just be right where I was. Grace is most definitely not the same, because I don't think any of us are the same. This quarantine has been hard. It has left our nervous systems in shock, questioning what the hell life was like before all of this shit hit the fan. And that is okay. Sometimes I think you just have to be knocked off your feet to be reminded of what strength is, of what humanity is, to be reminded of your ability to create your normal wherever you are. Allow all of that outer hip, your glute med, your QL to release right here. Especially in lots of sitting, it leaves for outer hip tightness. Any motion we're doing benefits from about 5 minutes and a half pigeon every single day.
What can I give that is all free?
Then slowly begin to rise back up. Sit your weight into your left hip, swivel your right leg around to the top right corner of your mat. Grab for your bolster wherever it is. Then inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, seated Janushirasana. Separate leg stretch. Let your elbows, your forehead, your nose surrender onto a bolster. Reach for the ground, your leggings, your ankle, your toe, whatever feels good and authentic for you. There's no right or wrong when you show up on your mat. That's something that we all need to remember. Yes, there's right or wrong when it comes to our alignment, when it comes to being safe, but after that, it's up to you. Today, I took a yoga class where forearm stand was our peak posture, and I laid in a belly down shavasana the whole time. On Zoom, looking like a pancake. I'm telling you, you just gotta do what's right for you. I even got complimented. She said, nice belly down shavasana. All that matters is that we feel seen and we feel loved and valued in exactly who we are right now. One more breath in. Breath out, rise back up. Set up for a wide-legged forward fold, so you can go forward, or like me, you can go around the length of your mat. You're gonna need one block, or one bolster, maybe two, if you want some more height. That could actually feel really good. Stack your bolsters up, and then inhale, reach your arms high. Exhale, seated wide-leg forward fold, surrender down. Point or flex your toes, it doesn't matter to me which, as long as you're consistent on both sides. Again, allow your head, neck, and shoulders to fall heavy. Your inner thighs are set up for this after you did this on both sides right before. So now's your chance to just sink in right down the middle. You're taking it onto your back after this, so know this is your last little moment. Seat it up. Every one of us processes all of this stuff differently. And I just want you all to remember that in order to be a channel of grace for those around you, you've got to accept and love yourself for how you're processing this in your own way. There is no relief if you don't give that relief to yourself. And if you're looking to everyone else around you to give you acceptance for who you are in this quarantine, never gonna feel fully satisfied. Still, that outward validation only goes so far in any time in our life. You have to find that love from within you to accept who you are in this quarantine, because here's a little known fact: you're always changing. Who you are in quarantine is gonna be different than who you were before and who you are after. Days and days and days in advance, you will change. Nothing is permanent besides the fact that we change and grow each and every day. So the better you get at loving yourself now, the better you will be at weathering the storms later on. Rise up through your hips and slowly begin to make your way all the way down onto your back. But before you do, begin to lay a bolster long so that you can lay on your spine. Let it mimic your spine vertically on your mat. And then begin to lay flat. If you have two, use the other one as a head and neck pillow. You're going to surrender down into Supta Baddha Konasana, where you'll bring the soles of your feet to touch and open your knees wide. Once you're in your butterfly pose, you have a few options. Option one, let your arms fall to your side, palms down to ground down, palms up to receive energy. Option two, grab your hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. Feel Our strength to ourselves. That's not something that as many people in our world we'd like to think lean into. So even though sometimes there feels like there's no end in sight, I want you to show gratitude for your journey and for your willingness to lean in and to show yourself grace. And as you lay here in stillness, be reminded of the fact that recovery is just as important as the hard work. I was actually in a stretch class the other day with Cece, who's in this class right now, and our instructor was talking about counting how many times this week you showed up for a rigorous workout, something where you knew you wanted to burn muscle, create strength. How many times you showed up just to recover? It's probably a lot less time in the recovery. And as you lay here, make a promise to yourself to increase the amount of times you want to recover. Because this time is not just mentally for you, it's physically too. Are like a muscle. You have to flex it and work it just as much as you do your physical muscles in order to change the negative thought patterns, to change the bad habits. You have to start holding yourself accountable to a greater life mentally. Slowly begin to grab for the outsides of your knees. And close them in like a book. Slide your pillow, your bolster out from underneath your spine and come to lay flat for just a moment. Set up for a bridge pose. Ground down through the soles of your feet. Inch your fingertips so close to your heels that they can graze. And then inhale, bridge pose. Lift your hips up and hold. Open up through your hips. This should feel like a great counterbalance after all of that closed hip work and compression through both your half pigeon and your hamstring stretching. Unchuck your chin from your chest. Yes, Peyton. He says hip stretches, very important. Feel yourself release. The perfect combination between effort and ease, bridge pose gives you an opportunity to find yourself in suspense. Gentle twist with your bolster. Drop your knees to the left. Send your gaze over your right shoulder. Ground down through your spine. Feel this gentle twist and allow your low spine some relief by squeezing through your bolster. That's why it's here. We are so lucky to be given this time to reset, to renew, to restore all together.
Underneath your knees so that you have a little bit of support underneath your legs if you crave that. This time completely for you. I'll call you out when it's time. But until then, allow yourself exactly what this posture means in Sanskrit, to surrender. Much of our reality right now is what everyone else wants us to see. Whether that's when we turn on the TV and watch the news, or we go onto Twitter and read what people are reading, or we see on Instagram what the world is doing. But we have to remember that it's exactly that. It's what people want us to see. It's the bright points of everyone's day, but it's also our chance to start the comparison game, comparing what we are doing to everyone else in our world. And if you're anything like me, likely comparing yourself as the lesser of the two. Peyton says, yes, lesser of the two. But what's so important is that we do remember that right now, projection is everything. And life is hard. We want to put things on our social media and we want to see things on the TV that make us happy. But we also can realize that our net happy positive number is a little bit lower than normal right now. That's why it's so important to work to be a channel of grace, because being grace to me in my mind is showing up as your authentic self, even if it's not the rosy, perfect version of you with all your makeup on and your best outfit. It's just you. Maybe your eyes are puffy from crying because life is just fucking hard sometimes. Maybe it's you with a full belly because you made makeshift Reese's as your dinner and your dessert all together in one, because I've been doing that recently. You show up as you are, and I guarantee you will find love in their heart to accept you, because authenticity is something that can't be recreated and can't be faked right now. Authenticity is something that everyone craves, whether they know it or not. And grace and authenticity have the ability, the capacity to be the same thing. Grace just has the acceptance in it together. So begin to ask yourself, how are you going to be a little bit more graceful in your life? And no, I don't mean graceful as in not tripping as you walk down the stairs, because stairs are hard. I trip up the stairs constantly. I mean, how are you going to give yourself a break in can start to love and accept who you are from the minute you wake up to sundown. Because if that's what you learn how to do when you come out of quarantine, you'll be better than the majority of the world. And that's a life task you'll be able to carry with you long after this pandemic passes. It'll easily carry you into at least our third or fourth global pandemic that we live through in our entire life. Right? Tee-hee. I'm kidding. But all jokes aside, know that you are loved and you are cherished for who you are. All of the good and the bad. Because so often there is so much more good than there is bad. And it takes so much more strength to lean into all of that goodness rather than to focus on the negative. Begin to invite some subtle movement back into your body. Wiggle through your fingertips and your toes, your ankles and your wrists. Then inhale, sweep both arms high up overhead as if you were just waking up for the first time today. Exhale, fetal posture either side. If you crave it, use one of your biceps as a pillow. Shavasana is corpse pose, the death of your practice. Fetal posture, the representation of rebirth, the chance to begin again. And oh, what a blessing it is that we get to constantly begin again in our lives. Be reminded of that true gift. Come to find an easy seat, Sukhasana, wherever you are. Sit up tall using your strong core muscles and find your hands in through heart center. Feel your thumbs to your chest, your heart beating underneath, your forever sign of your presence and how that is palpable and matters to those around you. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale. Release. Draw your thumbs to your third eye center, your seat of intuition, your Ajna chakra. I honor the place in all of you that is of light, love, truth, and peace because it's also within me. And in sharing that space, we all become one. We bow forward, we say, Namaste. I so love this because I can see all of your faces afterwards. That's beautiful. Everyone, thanks for coming tonight. I am going to be trying to kind of create a more sustainable way of showing my classes and having a place where they can call home after the live times, which for now is going to be YouTube. So know that I'm going to be trying to do these on Zoom so that I can have them recorded and shared. But yeah. Thank you all for coming. I love seeing all of your lovely faces. Know that if you have any postures you want to work on or anything that you haven't done restorative-wise before and you want to try it, let me know. Because I feel like I'm just learning with you guys when it comes to restorative and holding poses for a longer time. Have a great rest of your night. And thanks for bearing with my seventh grade hormonal boy of a dog who likes to hump my leg and bark and play fetch all while I'm trying to teach yoga. Moms really do it all. Have a great rest of your Sunday night, friends. Bye. Love you.
Thanks.
Bye, Jules.
Bye, Maggie.
Bye. Bye, Val. Bye, Annie.
Thanks.
Love you.
Love you.